सेंचुरी बीसी दैट इज 200 150 बीसी के आसपास के एक कुषाण कालीन या कुषाण से भी पहले की. इट्स प्रोबेबली द ओल्डेस्ट डेटेबल विष्णु स्कल्पचर इन द कंट्री. और जैसे आप देख सकते हैं उसको ऐसे पटक के रखा है उस म्यूजियम में, अब वहां इसकी कोई कदर नहीं. बट इट्स वर्थ इट्स वेट इन गोल्ड. अगर आप इंटरनेशनल मार्केट में उसको बेचे उसके सोने की कीमत आपको मिलेगी, उसके वजन की सोना आपको मिलेगा.
Subhuji,
I was going to talk to you mainly about this temple. This is called Bheem Kichak Temple. Local log isko Bheem Kichak Temple bolte hain, Devas Temple kehte hain. But aam taur pe Bheem Kichak isliye kehte hain ki do sajjan wahan khade hain unke kaaran. Unke bare mein main baad mein batata hoon.
Dr. Subhu,
bahar ka drishya. Hello, there's someone speaking.
Dr. Subhu, I just wanted to say two words, if you don't mind.
Please do. How do you do that?
Thank you. I have. Thank you.
Yeah, you can start.
If you can all hear me, I'm so sorry to have joined in a bit late. And I'm in Delhi, I have some meetings, but I was very, very keen for this webinar of extramural talks to start. And I'm very grateful to Dr. Subhu to have initiated this. The topic is very fascinating and of great interest to me. And I remember being to the first Shivalinga in India. It goes back to Gudimalam in Andhra Pradesh, and that also is dated to the same time or perhaps even a little earlier. So the topic is of great interest to all of us, and we all look forward to listening to Dr. Subramanian's learned exposition. I'm also happy that this will be the first of our talks which will be in person, for those who can make it to our seminar hall. And I hope that we continue in this fashion in an uninterrupted manner in the weeks to come. So with my few words and apologies for joining in late, I once again congratulate
unmute ho gaya. You can use this mic if you want.
Yeah. Thank you, Dr. Paranjpe, for that introduction. This temple is not 2nd century BC. This temple is 6th century AD. That sculpture piece was 2nd century BC, like Gudimallam, but this temple is quite late. You can see the side view. We'll come back to some of these little later. I just wanted to give you an idea of the extent of the temple. Yeah, move nahi kar raha. Okay. This is another site. You can see that it has a typical what is called the Adhishtana of a temple. Niche, you can see the Upapita, then you can see the big band, thick band. उसके ऊपर एक जिसको कपोत बंद कहते हैं वगैरह वगैरह. I don't want to go into those details, but this is a typical temple basement structure. Now I come to the main part of the entrance of the temple. You can see this person standing there, and there is a second panel behind him. There's this lady standing there, and there's a third panel right behind another lady standing there. So I'll start with this gentleman on the outside. This person who is standing there is supposed to be a Dwarpal. As you can see, he is very different from the normal Dwarpal. Kisi mandir mein jayenge, you will go to a temple, the Dwarpal is supposed to stop you from entering. So he's always armed to the teeth, literally to the teeth, because his teeth really comes out. If you go to any South Indian temple, you will find his, he will be, and he's supposed to look offensive, and he's always fully armed. And he basically stops you from entering. But this chap, as you can see, has a totally different mudra. He is extremely benign. He is not armed. And he is holding what is called a chin mudra, a meditative mudra. Chin mudra, agar aap is taraf dekhenge, to it's held like this, right? And it's a meditative posture. He's actually preparing you for a meditative experience inside the temple. He's not trying to stop you. The only similar Dwarpal you'll get to see, who is not an offensive person to stop you, is in Sanchi. Sanchi ke jo stoop mein jo Dwarpal hai, wo na keval koi hathiyar leke nahi khada, he doesn't hold any arms, but instead he has a welcoming flower in his hand. So that is the alternative tradition, as I would call, for a Dwarpal. And this image sort of follows the Sanchi tradition. I just wanted to, a sculpture or any temple has to be seen in different lights, different angles, different distances to actually appreciate it. So many of these panels will be repetition, but just to give you a different view. You can see the detail of the head, you can see the meditative intensity of his face, and also the hairstyle. He is very careful about maintaining his hairstyle. Ab dekhiye, he actually worked a lot on his hair. So this is the entrance. Unka kapda hai. Oh, sorry. sorry for standing up. I hope you are able to see the details of his dhoti. Maybe in another panel, I'll be able to show you the... Actually, the dhoti is not plain. Huh? It is extremely intricately designed dhoti. We'll come to some more detail, I hope. I'll come to this lady who is standing there behind. She is supposed to be Yamuna. On both sides of the gate, on one side you will have Yamuna, and the other side it will be Ganga. This is a very conventional thing, because Madhya Desh, which is lying between Ganga and Yamuna, is the sacred space. Therefore, all sacred spaces will be enclosed by these two rivers on both sides. So this is Yamuna. She is typically standing under a mango tree. Those fruits hanging on the top of her are mangoes. She's standing on her vahan, which is kachua, or what do you call it, tortoise. And the whole thing is held up by a character called Bharvahak. He is the proletarian of our temple architecture, who holds everything on his head. So we'll come to this chap a little later. But you can see the structure of the composition this way. We'll see more of this lady. You can see the arm ka pair and her hand, and she's holding a garland, thick garland in her hand. You can see her dress. She's not naked at all. She's wearing a dress, and you can see the patta going over her breasts. And you can see the finger, the naturalism of her finger because of the morning light coming from behind. This is her head. Again, she is very careful with her headdress. These are her feet and the kachua under her. Okay. On the other side is Ganga and the other gentleman, Dwarpal. But unfortunately, this other Dwarpal's head has been cut off, so we can't see how he looks. So we'll focus more on the lady, Ganga. You can see that Ganga's posture is very different. It's almost a haughty posture. You know, she has that air about her. And you'll see more of that. You can just see that in her face and the bearing of her whole body and the way she's looking at it. You know, there's a certain haughtiness to her. You can see that, you know, in the hand gesture. And this gentleman right at the bottom, this chehra hai, is an interesting character. I wanted to focus. Can you see the details of her dress? The sari mein jo designs bane hai. Can you see? It's extremely intricate design of her sari. And you see this gentleman right at the bottom, right? So he's a grotesque character. He's a short kind of kya kehte hain vaman, what do you kehte hain, dwarf, okay, sorry, pramath keh sakte hain, dwarf keh sakte hain, he's not a gana, but he's very funny kind of a character. He actually gives you a counterpoint to this lady who is standing high above him. I don't know what is the psychological makeup. Why is he there at all? What is he supposed to be doing there? Someone more knowledgeable should be able to explain this. But it's, if you look at it, the whole composition, he has a role to play in it, in that composition, as a contrast to the elegance and aristocratic bearing of this lady. Gupta art is supposed to be highly aristocratic, sophisticated, cultured art. So it represents very what is called Nagaraka of our friend who wrote that book, the Kama text, Vatsyayana. The Nagaraka is the urban, cultured, civilized person. So they are the people worthy of being represented in Gupta art, and you'll find them. So this whole Ganga panel is held by this Bharwak, who also is Vamadev. Shiva ka ek roop hai. He likes his cup of wine, so he always holds a cup of wine in his hands. You can see it here. He is not at all bothered by the weight of the river on his top, but he's quite relaxed with his drink. This is the other chap. But again, I wanted to show the intricacy of his. That is the beauty of these sculptures, that they focus so much on these elegant details. Now, on the door jamb inside, there are a set of panels. So I think there are about 5 to 10 panels, 5 panels on one side and 5 on the other. This shows elephants frolicking on a pool of water, but it is related to some Shiva Puran story, which I have not been able to put my finger on. It has all these skeleton-like characters there. And what are they doing? I don't know. अच्छा, द प्राइजेस फॉर आइडेंटिफाइंग दिस पैनल क्या है ये बताएंगे? Maya Devi? No, this is a Shiva temple, no Maya Devi.
Okay, then this is Shiva and Parvati getting married.
Okay, this is Shiva Bhikshatana. Okay, we live in pine forest, but I suppose the Chhattisgarhians didn't know what a pine forest meant. Shiva is going out in the pine forest. I don't know whether you know the story. There is this group of rishis who are supposed to be very haughty. They don't think much of him, Shiva. So in order to humble them, Shiva comes with his Brahma Kapal in his hand, begging for food. In normal descriptions, he is totally naked, but in cultural representation, they normally don't show nakedness. Shiva goes out begging in the streets of the rishis' houses. Rishis are, of course, busy doing their yajna. The women folk of the rishis come out. They are totally enamored of this chap. And you can see that they are, in every description, it's stated they are unmindful of the sadis slipping out of their waist. You can see that lady, that so-called Shalabanjika, is actually trying to hold back her sadi. And it's slipping away from her waist. So that is the detail that you catch. This is one of the earliest representations of Shiva Bhikshatana that I have seen. You get more of them in South Indian sculptures. Lepakshi mein jayenge. There's a beautiful three-dimensional sculpture of this, very interesting sculpture. A lot has been written about this, but no one has written. But not just this particular piece. I would like you to look at the entire composition, the framing of this piece, the borders and the three stages in which it is coming to us. The richness of the ornamentation that goes into it. This is what she had mentioned earlier. This is Shiva's marriage to Parvati. This is on the other side of the wall, and you can see Brahma with his fire. Then there is Vishnu standing out with his kalash. He is going to gift away a Parvati to Shiva, and there is this Ganas and various other characters lining up next. This is the holy, happy family of Shiva up in Kailash. Those rocks they are sitting on. And Parvati is sitting on the lap of Shiva in a fairly difficult posture. I wonder if anyone has tried twisting themselves like that. But you can see the Ganas playing on the bottom, and this Kartikey on that peacock. And there is the chap sitting right at the bottom, Kartikey ke niche. He's not an ascetic, he's some Bhairav type of character. I mean, he's some skeleton-ish character. But again, the richness of the whole background, the intricacy of the carving. Us site mein ek tube jaise dikh raha hai aapko. Jiske niche ek kalash laga hua hai. You can see a kalash on the side panel. It's actually a hollow tube. It's hollow inside. You can put your dhaga under piro ke nikal sakte hain. The whole, and it's some 20 feet high. And it's a hollow tube. It's carved with such beauty and care. And this is a very interesting aspect. Usi ke niche ek panel hai. Can anyone, I already written the name, so no problem. This Mahisha Mardini. Kal se Nav Durga shuru ho raha hai. So this is actually how they prepare to work on a piece of rock. They have done the sketch
on the rock, and now it will be carved out. So this actually tells you the procedures for making the sculptures. So ek rough drawing banaya pure composition ka, or I suppose they will start working on it. Now this is the back side of the temple. You can see that there is a niche for jisko kosht kehte hain, dev kosht kehte hain. That's actually depressed lower. Normal height se thoda usko niche le aayega, which is very unusual for a temple. I'll go into some of the usme jo small small shrines andar niche bane hain, unme kahi kahi bahut hi nayab sculptures hain aur very miniature sculptures. Some of these I found very fascinating, so I thought I'll share them. This is a king with his two consorts having a cup of wine. This is a very small piece, must be about 6 inches by 6 inches or so. So these are Gandharvas who are flying up or flying down, whatever they are doing, I don't know. This chap has a sword, I don't know what he intends to do with it. These are decorative motifs on the wall. But you can see at the corner, there is a very interesting lady. Ek us taraf corner mein ek mahila dikh rahi hai. We'll see a little more of her. You can see that, you know, if she's just emerging from a corner, almost looks like, you know, she's negotiating with a very windy day. It gives you that feel of, it's a dhvani of a windy day in the sculpture. So this is Chandrashala, as it is called. It actually represents a house. Beech mein jo hai, that slit in the middle is actually a door. You'll see more of it in the next one. Here is a lady who is either waiting for someone. Ek darwaza khula, ek part khula, ek band hai. She's glancing out, waiting for someone on the street. Who is she or whom is she waiting for? We don't know. But there's a very common image in the old Sanskrit literature of ladies coming out to see a procession. This is there in Ashwaghosh, Buddha Charita, where ladies stream out of their house to see when Buddha Siddhartha steps out. Or it could be something else where this lady is just waiting for a husband to come, or a daughter to come, or a son to come. This is Vishnu, flanked by pillars, with beautifully carved pillars on both sides. He is riding on Garud. And this is two wives next to him. It's again very beautifully carved. And there are two Hans right at the bottom, if you can locate them. That two Hans there. Then there are, this is a isolated door jamb. Niche wahan alag se pada hai. It has this Naga creeper. And this Naga or Nagavalli kehte hain, uspe Gandharva log latke hue hain. So that is the motif in this. But I find this Gandharva very effortlessly clinging to this. It gives a very interesting, it's a very typical Gupta image.
Hello, namaskar, sasriya kaal, assalamu alaikum. Tanish Tata ka ad jo darsha raha tha.
Ye kahan se aa gaya? Okay. So there are many of these chaps. You can have a look at them. Then there is another small piece outside which has this amorous couple, nobleman with his lady. Then this in the museum there, this is a Narasimha. This is again a couple. This is in that museum, I mean, was site museum hai, usme ek pillar hai. This is just a pillar which has about 6 to 8 sides to that pillar. And carved on that pillar, on the sides of the pillar, are the scenes from Ramayana. And one episode from Ramayana, which is the Vali episode. Okay. So each side has a small panel. It's just not more than 6 inches panel, each of them, which shows the entire Vali episode. Here is Vali and his wife sitting on a throne. Happy married life. Everything is fine. But meanwhile, Sugriva is being coronated out in the jungle. We can see they're all monkeys. You can see the tails. Unfortunately, face cut. Okay. You know what is happening here? Ram ji jo hai apna teer saad rahe. And these are the two brothers fighting. So one of them is going to get it. And he's got it here. So Vali is lying, dying, niche dikh raha, and he is on the lap of someone, probably Sugriv or Angad, we don't know who is on the lap. There is one monkey chap standing and Ram there. And obviously Vali is asking certain uncomfortable questions of Ram. This is Tara ka vilap, Tara and probably another wife, so grief. Stricken, sorrowing over the death of this gentleman, and probably that other is a funeral. Outside, in the open, बहुत सारे sculptures रखे हुए हैं. उनमें से मुझे ये खास, जिसको मैं Colossus Shiva नाम मैंने दिया है, बहुत ही अद्भुत शिला शिल्प है. I just want to show you more of this, just to give you an idea of the size of this. Like 5 feet ka waist tak. Koi bhi lady hai, wo scale ke liye khadi ho gayi. Or this is Shiva, and you can see him in the morning light. तीसरा आंख है वगैरह वगैरह इन अ डीप मेडिटेटिव पोस्चर. दिस इज कार्व्ड ऑफ अ काइंड ऑफ रॉक विच इज अनबिलीवेबली बैड. ये रॉक क्या है, वो क्ले जैसे है, वो खराब होता है, वो फूट के निकल जाता है. बट दिस हैज बीन देयर फॉर 1500 ईयर्स, नियरली 1500 ईयर्स. After 1500 years, you are able to see it, and this is the image that we get. You can see, I mean, from different angles. You can see how the, you know, the rock quality is here, ki wo burbura ho jata hai. So that is Malhar for you. Now, if you have any questions on this particular sequence, we'll take it. Otherwise, I'll go on to the next temple. Yes.
I'm intrigued by the presence of Vishnu and Shiva in the same temple here. But I was visiting a South Indian city. I was taken to Shiva temple and Vishnu temple. And it seemed that the devotees of each do not go to the other temple.
See, South India, Shaivism, Vaishnavism became very competitive during the Vijayanagara period. Late Chola and Vijayanagara period, they became very competitive and exclusive. But this is not true for rest of the country. वो एक ही मंदिर में सारे भगवान लोग आपको मिल जाएंगे. दैट काइंड ऑफ सेक्टेरियनिज्म विद इन हिंदुइज्म यू विल फाइंड मोर इन द विजयनगरा रूल्ड एरियाज वेयर शैविज्म एंड वैष्णविज्म इमर्ज्ड एज वेरी डिस्टिंक्ट एंड अपोजिंग रिलीजियस ट्रेडिशंस.
व्हाट अबाउट द विजयनगर राया
That's the other problem. You see, officially they were all ruling on behalf of a Shiva, विरूपाक्ष करके वहां मंदिर है विजयनगर में. इनफैक्ट ऑल रॉयल ऑर्डर्स वर एक्चुअली साइंड इन द नेम ऑफ विरूपाक्ष. द किंग साइन विल ऑलवेज बी श्री विरूपाक्ष. King will not sign his name. But they were all, most of them were Vaishnavites. Like Krishnadevaraya is known to have been a very important Vaishnavite king. He composed a lot of Vaishnavite texts also. But these kings, like all good kings, patronize all sects. They want to be on the safe side. So they are not so anti this or that. They may have personal preference, but they, most of them, like Aurangzeb, Krishnadev Raya ho, they generally keep on the right side of all religions. They don't antagonize. But coming back to this temple,
also place, with the account kind of read that the heads of military bands, called the Nayakas or Nakras, they're more powerful than the king. But all of them pay obeisance to a ritual sovereignty of the king was respected by all.
Well, I'll not comment on this because that takes me away from art history. But yeah, there is, you're right about that. There's been, much has been written about the so-called ritual sovereignty of South Indian kings, but we'll do that later when we do political theory. The important thing about many of these panels, which I think many of the South Indian Shaiva temples, for some very strange reason, they foreground the killing of Wali. Now, I don't know why, frankly. Ellora mein, you go to the Kailash temple, there's a huge panel of same thing. Same episode is represented in Ellora in Kailash temple, which is a Shaivite temple. Now, why are they foregrounding of all the episodes in Ramayana, why are they foregrounding something which put Rama in slightly difficult light? I mean, that could be some mischief about that. But anyway, we... I can't say anything more because the whole sculptural program of this temple is not clear. There's one Vishnu, because Vishnu as a Dig Devata has to be represented in every Shiva temple. Even in all South Indian temples, if you go, even Brihadishwara temple, so there will be a one of these niches outside will have Vishnu. Vishnu, Surya, Indra, they all have to be there.
I'm talking about that famous Tamil of the Kodam. So, was he immediately Niche there?
No, that cat is supposed to be imitating Arjuna's penance.
I was thinking whether there is this.
No, this is not a cat, this is a dwarf.
And secondly, sir, Joe Gandhavala image you showed, to really that, you know, emaciated form.
It's unlikely because the, I mean, I didn't show all the panels. There's another panel which shows a large number of them. They may be Pishach because Shiv generally hangs around with these characters. They could be the rishis, emaciated rishis. We don't know. Someone who is more knowledgeable with Shaiva texts should be able to tell us. So, five panels. I just showed you one panel out of the five because the other panels I thought may not interest people so much. So, I just focused on one. Aap kuch puchhiye.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
Achha,
sir, you will have a lot. Now, you heard all of that.
Dusra.
So many interests in so many areas. And here we are getting you from. I have art historian or historian of art, architecture.
As a viewer of art. Art day.
But I would call you as an art historian of art, architecture. My question is that how and why did you call or give the title of Malhar?
Ush Jagah ka naam. Jagah ka naam. Place is called Malhar. Tala. भी उसी जगह का नाम है, मेरा दिया हुआ नाम नहीं. So we'll go to Tala. Tala is very different because it is a place where I find humor as a dominant just a minute, we'll get onto the screen. Okay. So in Tala, three features or four features which strike me as most fascinating is that there is a huge sense of humor in this place. Yeah? I never found so much humor striking you at the very first exposure to this temple. Mm-hmm. Humor is the dominant mode. I mean, I read humor in it. Probably those chaps are very serious about it. But to me, it is, you know, humor is a very underlying theme. There's nothing staid about it. It's very humorous. Second thing is something which I call naturalism, extremely naturalist. And third is, extreme kind of experimentation. Is one of the most experimental architects and sculptors in the world. So it's a very beautiful place to visit to and to have an experience of totally different kind of architecture. It has happened within 30 years of building of the other temple. That's what strikes me, that the two stand in such contrast to each other that it fascinates me. But I just wanted to show you this lotus, huge lotus on a beam. ऐसे जो बीम बनते हैं ना उसमें है तो नीचे से देखे तो यू विल सी दैट लोटस अभी तो जमीन पे पड़ा है बट इफ यू सी दैट ईच पेटल ऑफ द लोटस इज कार्व्ड इंडिपेंडेंटली आई विश आई कुड जूम इन मोर बट अभी करूंगा तो गड़बड़ हो जाएगा बीच में जो यू सी दैट सेंट्रल व्हाट इज इट व्हाट पार्ट ऑफ द लोटस फ्लावर इज दैट एनीवे जिसमें बीज होते हैं ना कमल के बीज होते हैं गोल गोल ईच ऑफ दोज बीज आर रिप्रेजेंटेड देयर मीन सर्कल्स उसमें बने हैं सो दैट्स अमाउंट ऑफ डिटेलिंग आई नेवर सीन अ लोटस बीइंग सो केयरफुली डेवलप्ड यू नो इन एनी अदर प्लेस लोटस तो हिंदुस्तान में इतना होता है आजकल इतना उसका हम यूज करते हैं डिसयूज करते हैं बट दिस यू विल सी दैट such elaborate work on the theme. Aaj iska ye roop hai. It's just after recovery, it was just a mount when it was first found. But mitti clear kiya to ye aaj dikh raha hai. So we are trying to imagine the splendor of this place from this. I'll just show you briefly some of these statues. You see this chap holding it, okay? He's a bharvark, uske upar sculpture kuch rakha tha jo abhi nahi hai. You see this chap. Normal bharvark jo hai acche se khade honge. Ye dekho taang se ek haath hai aur ek taang hai. Ulta khada hai. It is just having fun. और ये भी देखिए इसी दिस लिंटल उसमें एक शेर का मुंह आ जाता है दिस उसी के ऊपर वाला है ये एक्सट्रीमली नेचुरलिस्टिक उसका चेहरा देखिए उसके बाल घुमरालपन इट्स अ वेरी नेचुरलिस्टिक थिंग और ये देखिए ये बहुत ही मजेदार है दिस अ टाइगर लुकिंग आउट ऑफ अ विंडो और अपना हाथ एक के ऊपर एक रख के वो देख रहा है कि यार जनों का दर्शन कर रहा है. आई रियली फाउंड दिस एक्सट्रीमली ह्यूमरस. होगा कुछ रिचुअल, कोई देवता रहे होंगे, क्या पता, अपने को नहीं मालूम, बट आई फाइंड यू नो आई कांट मिस द ह्यूमर इन इट. ये मकर है, मगरमच्छ. With the various kinds of animals being put to various uses in this place, it's just amazing. And this designs, which I call actually, with due apologies to other people, the other art historian here, I almost find it Mughlai. You know, we just see the foliage and the floral designs. इसके बाद नो यू आई फाइंड दिस काइंड ऑफ थिंग ओनली इन द पिएट्रा डूरा वर्क दैट यू फाइंड इन ताजमहल. ये जो अंदाज है, ये कुछ हो गया गड़बड़. ओके, आर यू एबल टू सी? या, दिस आर वेरी ब्यूटिफुल फ्लोरल डिजाइन्स दैट आर बीइंग यूज्ड. This is a pillar. There's a horse sleeping out of a kalash. Niche kalash hai. Kalash se, I mean, kamal ka phool to nikal hi raha hai, but do ghode bhi nikal rahe hai. You can see a mat being used. This is a mat motif. Mat ke beech mein kamal hai, but see the realism of the mat. These are diagonal bands, it's more of them.
Yes, sir. These are Anji Bolte.
The price is for identifying.
Okay.
Okay.
Theek.
Okay. Haan, phone number dilaya, phone karke 39 ke liye to me kare. Theek.
Okay. Haan? Okay.
Hello,
kuch participant is joined.
अच्छा, कैन समवन आइडेंटिफाई दिस चेहरा?
चेहरा तो है ही.
हाँ, चेहरा हो तो प्रॉब्लम क्या है? त्रिभंगी. ये त्रिभंगी नहीं है. हाँ, त्रिभंगी नहीं है. No, okay. This is Shiva Nataraja. Natesha. Okay. Now, Shiva wears Shardula Charmambara, right? Tiger skin. So, I'll just show you the tiger. Tiger ka face hai. Can you see that? एंड ये दो चीजें लटक रहे हैं ना, ये पंजे हैं टाइगर के. दिस अ टाइगर स्किन दैट शिवा इज वेयरिंग, बट इट्स सच अ ब्यूटिफुल डांसिंग स्कल्पचर. एंड दिस इज द वेस्ट बैंड, दिस इज द अदर टू पंजास. दिस अनदर, वहां भी एक साइट म्यूजियम है जहां जितने कलेक्ट हुए थे वो पटके रखे हैं. So, I mean, this place is slightly better kept than the other one, but ये एक महिला का waist है, हाँ, ये मेखला कहते हैं ना उसको, the waist band है, and the साड़ी भी है underneath, okay? You can see the, you know, detailing of the both the साड़ी and the waist band. ये पाँव है. What I was saying about the naturalism of this place. ये हाथ है किसी का, किसी का सिर है. ये एक ऋषि जी है who is squatting. Why is he squatting? It's a big sculpture. It's almost life size. What is he doing squatting? We don't know, but it's such a lifelike naturalist representation of this person. अब उसका चेहरा देखिए, दाढ़ी वाड़ी, सॉरी इज बैक। ये गुरु और शिष्य हैं, ये शिष्य साइड में खड़ा है, ये इज अनदर जस्ट द टॉर्सो ऑफ अनदर पर्सन, दिस इज अ वॉचमैन। I mean, just see the intensity on this face, you know. I mean, intense meditative quality of whoever this person is. It's the depth of contemplation that can be represented in sculpture. That's just amazing. हाँ, ये ताला का सबसे प्रसिद्ध आइकन है। सब लोग, जितने लोगों ने उसको देखा है, सबकी अपनी थियरी है। So everyone tries to tell you what this is all about. It was found there, and not inside the temple, but outside the temple. But when you see, and I just call it Tala Weirdo. Now you see this chap in close up, you will understand why he is such a weird chap. Every part of his body is made up of an animal. Kaan jo hai, more hai. सिर पे बाल जो है, दे आर स्नेक्स। हिज चिन इज मेड ऑफ क्रैब एंड हिज नोज इज छिपकली, क्या कहते हैं, लिजर्ड। एंड वी विल सी मोर ऑफ द डिटेल्स सो यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड। आईज, वी विल सी मोर ऑफ द आईज। Eye is actually a toad, mendak. Mendak hai ya fish, pata nahi, mendak laga mujhe.
Lips are fish.
Lips are fish and the mooch is, I think uska hai, chipkali ka paav hai. Nahi, nahi, mooch is the, this thing, fish. This is the eye. What is it? I think it's a mendak, no? Yeah, fish. Or eyebrow bhi uska wo chipkali ka form.
This also looks grotesque.
That's the whole point. And the shoulder. This is the shoulder, makar. Haath jo hai, wo ungli saap hai. I don't know whether it's humor or this is penis and the testicles. Penis is a tortoise, testicles are two ganti. So this is अभी जो पहले देखा था वो जेठानी के मंदिर थी, अब देवरानी के मंदिर है। अब जेठानी के मंदिर तो टूट फूट गया, देवरानी के मंदिर थोड़ा बचा है। And देवरानी के मंदिर has some beautiful sculpture. We'll see some of them here. This is how it looks today, but before us, जो भी twin मंदिर होते हैं वो ऐसे ही होते हैं, सास बहु देवरानी जेठानी हो जाता है। सास बहु तो वो सहस्रबाहु मंदिर है उधर आपके ही उदयपुर के पास। This is the door jamb. You can see the intricacy of the carving on this. Can you see a lion somewhere there? एक शेर का मुंह दिख रहा है, कीर्ति मुखा कहते हैं इसको, ऑन द राइट साइड। हाँ, नाउ शेर है, अब वो शेर को कैसे होना चाहिए, शेर जैसे होना चाहिए। अब क्लोजअप में देखो, द शेर डिसॉल्व्स इनटू समथिंग एल्स। यू सी हाउ दिस शेर का मुंह इज कंपोज्ड। It's almost Chinese. It's like a Chinese dragon. See, but each part, you know, everything is dissolved into something else. You know, that's Hanji. Nahi, wo to shayad shading ke liye hua hai, but dikhega to aise dikhega aapko. Wo contrast dikhane ke liye shayad colors bani hai. And this is the door jam. और वो जैसे मैंने वहां ट्यूब बताया था, वहां भी एक ट्यूब बना है, अंदर से हॉलो होता है। और डोर जैम के ऊपर देर आर दिस 15 जेंटलमैन सिटिंग नेक्स्ट टू बिहाइंड ईच अदर एंड होल्डिंग अ हैंड ओवर द अदर. अब कर क्या रहे हैं, क्या गेम खेल रहे हैं पता नहीं. ये गेम है, रिचुअल है, क्या है, आई डोंट नो. दिस इज एक्चुअली अ गेम. यू सी द टू पैनल्स मीन द डैमेज्ड है बट दे एक्सट्रीमली ब्यूटिफुल मिनिएचर गुप्ता पीरियड कार्विंग्स. जो बीच का पैनल है दैट इज शिवा एंड पार्वती प्लेइंग अ गेम ऑफ डाइस. ये एक कहानी लोगों ने सुना है. शिवा सी अनलाइक वॉट आइंस्टाइन थॉट गॉड्स डू नॉट प्ले डाइस. This is a very famous statement of Einstein regarding क्या बोलते हैं भाई जो भी है. But Shiva and Parvati are playing dice and obviously Shiva has to lose and he cheats and is caught in the act. So Parvati holds his hand. Ellora में बहुत सुंदर खूब बड़ा पैनल है. इस पे बहुत गजब का पैनल है वो, जिसमें जो गणों का जो द प्ले ऑफ द गणास इन दैट पैनल इज रियल मार्वल. इफ यू हैव एवर बीन टू एलोरा दैट समथिंग यू शुड नॉट मिस. मीन बच्चे क्या उदम कूद मस्ती कर सकते हैं वो उन पैनलों में आप देख सकते हैं. यहां भी वो हो रहा है बट वो आई विश आई कुड शो बेटर फोटोग्राफ्स ऑफ दिस. इन द सेंट्रल पैनल शिवा एंड पार्वती आर देयर. द साइड पैनल I wish I can show this, but सबसे नीचे एक बुल है, दिख रहा है? हाँ, and उसके ऊपर तीन चार ये गण जो हैं वो कुछ कर रहे हैं. This bull has been pledged by Shiva. Shiva का अपना जो नंदी है, he has been pledged in this game of dice. So Shiva has lost the bull. So Parvati's ganas are taking charge of the bull. That is the story that's here. So, I hope some other panels details you can see. But this is the other part, other panels in this. अब इसमें आप देखेंगे लोगों के हेयर स्टाइल, देखिए किसी एक का हेयर स्टाइल जो है दूसरे जैसे नहीं होगा. ओके, आई थिंक दैट शुड बी द लास्ट. ओके, दैट्स इट. थैंक यू. So, any question, comment on?
It's a very nice question that I asked. Like, these are very old users. The first one was from the
Rudis, I think. The Vishnu Rudis.
So, the historians generally talk about all the faces and dress. So, would a historian also imagine that such was the kind of people the god is made in the image of? Like they say, like very much thicker face hair, very more gentle and like very elegant face. Like Vishnu is extremely elegant. Later we see more, you know, full bodies.
तो फुल बॉडी पीपल तो ये भी थे जो द्वारपाल थे. द इश्यू इज नॉट फुल बॉडी. सी हाउ डू यू इमेजिन रिप्रेजेंट गॉड्स, दैट इज अ मेजर इश्यू इन इंडियन आर्ट राइट फ्रॉम द बिगिनिंग. निहारंजन रे की बहुत सुंदर किताब है, कभी पढ़ना है, आइडिया एंड इमेज इन इंडियन आर्ट, वेयर द कॉन्सेप्चुअलाइजेशन ऑफ बुद्धा image. How does it happen? How do you imagine the supreme consciousness which Buddha has attained? बोधि को पत्थर में कैसे दिखाना है इन द फॉर्म ऑफ अ ह्यूमन बीइंग. हाउ दिस आइडिया इवॉल्व्स, बिकॉज यू आर नॉट ट्राइंग टू शो बुद्ध के चेहरा ऐसा था, यू आर ट्राइंग टू शो हिज बोधिनेस थ्रू द स्कल्पचर. हाउ डज इट इवॉल्व? द सेम थिंग हैपन्स विथ ऑल द गॉड्स. देर इज अ सर्टन इंट्रिंसिक character you attribute to the gods and you try to figure out how to represent them, which is why they are not, there's been old debate in Indian art ki hum log naturalist kyun nahi the, realism kyun nahi hai, why are these hands not muscular when it should have been muscular, vagera. And this is a way you imagine divinity. However, there are sculptures which do not show gods, which show ordinary human beings, and not even elite human beings. There you will find a totally different way of representing. मैं एक example आपको दूँ. देवगढ़ एक जगह है हमारे मध्य प्रदेश में है, झांसी के पास. Very famous for its Vishnu temple. On the bottom of the temple, there are panels of Nand Gop and family. There, they had to show not elite people, but they had to show cowherds. That iconography is very different. I mean, oh, dress, unka khade hone ke tarike. I mean, Nand and do bachche hain. तो नंद जी के पास भी एक बच्चा होगा और यशोदा के हाथ में भी एक बच्चा होगा. यशोदा बिल्कुल एक जाटनी जैसे दिखेंगी आपको, उनके ड्रेस और उनके पूरा पोशाक. सो व्हेन दे एक्चुअली रिप्रेजेंट ऑर्डिनरी पीपल, दे ट्राई टू डू इट डिफरेंटली. देन देयर इज अ थर्ड थिंग व्हिच इज आई थिंक एंटायर इंडियन आर्ट ट्राइज टू कॉन्ट्रास्ट दिस इमेज ऑफ डिविनिटी विद इमेज ऑफ ग्रोटेस्कनेस. So this ganas play a very important role in bringing out the grotesqueness of the contrast. I mean, aap Sanchi mein chale jao, kahin bhi chale jao, the gana is so important in the concept. But I say main to kitne drafts to maine zindagi mein kabhi nahi dekhe jitne yahan ke panels mein jaate. So it's not a normal thing that they are trying to represent. They are trying to, they have a scheme in their head which they are trying to bring.
I was very surprised by the use of the Dwarapala.
They are very aristocratic. Gupta art is an extremely aristocratic art.
There should have been dresses at that
time. Obviously, aise gungrale baal nahi banenge, unke baal aise ban jayenge. अब एक देखिए, हर एक का बाल जो है, महिला हो या पुरुष हो, बहुत ही स्टाइलाइज्ड. सी, इट इज नॉट स्टाइलाइज्ड इन अ स्टाइलाइज्ड वे, इट इज अ नेचुरल
वे.
हेयर कॉम्बिंग इज स्टाइलाइज्ड. सी, दिस आर नॉट स्टाइलाइज्ड स्कल्पचर्स. इफ यू गो टुवर्ड्स द मिडिवल पीरियड, यू विल फाइंड मच मोर स्टाइलाइज्ड एंड रिपीटेटिव. पैसे वालों के पास लेजर ही लेजर है, हम लोगों के पास है.
Of course
we have. Why are we writing books? We are writing books, you see. That's a leisure activity.
एक तो ये मुझे इतना अच्छा लगा और इसका जो असर जो मेरे ऊपर हुआ वो भी मैं थोड़ा शेयर करूंगा. ये हम लोग छत्तीसगढ़ में जाता रहा हूँ और वहाँ इसकी चर्चा भी सुनता रहा हूँ कि बिहार में कुछ आपको देखने को मिल सकता है हिस्टोरियन. लेकिन जो मतलब मैं जाता भी वहाँ पर गया हूँ तो भी इस तरह से मूर्तियों को देखने का हम लोग का अभ्यास है, मंदिरों को ऐसे देखने का अभ्यास है. अब हम लोग इस तरह के आर्ट के को समझने के लिए शायद तैयार नहीं है. मैं सोच रहा था कि जैसे हम लोग इसको देख रहे हैं और इसको एक हिस्ट्री के उसमें लाने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं, एक आदमी जो पढ़ा लिखा नहीं है उस तरह से, इतिहास का ज्ञान उसको नहीं है, वो बहुत आसानी से इन बातों को समझ सकता है। ये बात मुझे समझ आ रही है। आर्ट हिस्टोरियन इज द वर्स्ट गाइड टू दीज काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स, ऐसा मुझे लगा ही मन शेयर था। नहीं मैं इसको कंप्लीट कर लूँ क्योंकि हम लोग जिस तरह से इस तरह की कलाकृतियों को देखने की अभ्यस्त होते हैं उस गेज में ही ऐसा कुछ आ जाता है कि हम उसमें कुछ शैव और वैष्णव के डिविजन्स, उनके प्लेसमेंट, उनकी पोजिशन और भारवाहक में कोई एक सामाजिक लोग थे जो उठाते थे वजन पूरे समाज का आदि आदि खोलने का अभ्यास। ये जो हमारी दृष्टि है जो हमारे पास्ट में सिर्फ और सिर्फ विभाजित करने वाली चीजों को देखने की खोजी आंख बन गई है, उसने हम लोगों को बड़ी क्षति पहुंचाई। और ये भाव मेरे मन में जो उठे वही मैं आपसे शेयर कर रहा हूँ कि ये बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट है मेरे लिए कि जब भी इन चीजों को मैं देखता हूँ तो मैं क्या देखूँ, ये एक सवाल मिल जाता है। वही हम लोगों की दृष्टि जो है वो एक तरह से क्या कहना चाहूंगा प्रदूषित हो। मैंने देखा कि आप जितने लिखा रहे हैं उसमें जो बहुत सारे गैप्स नहीं छूट रहे हैं, तब एक जो एक जब एक मूर्ति है उसके आगे पीछे ऊपर नीचे कुछ न कुछ चीजें आई हैं और उन चीजों के आने में जानवर भी आ गए हैं और जो जीवन में हम लोग देखी हुई चीजें हैं उन सबका रिप्रेजेंटेशन उसमें आया है। लेकिन हमारी निगाह में ये जो आपस में होलिस्टिक जीवन दृष्टि जो हुई रही होगी उस समय की जो भी हम देखते हैं उसके साथ संपर्क जो है हमारा बनता हमारी कला का होता है। मैं जब बंगाल में जो पूजा के समय में मैं जब लोगों की कल्पनाओं के बारे में देखता हूँ कि वो क्या कैसे कैसे इमेजिन कर रहे हैं तो मुझे बहुत अच्छा लगता है कि जो कुछ भी हमने देखा है अगर कोई इस वक्त कोई बहुत बड़ी बड़ी कुछ घटना घट गई है रॉकेट के बारे में तो वो रॉकेट भी उसमें लाने की कोशिश करते हैं क्योंकि वो जो पूजा में जब सजावट होती है तो उसमें जो भी उसके आसपास जीवन में है उसको रिप्रेजेंट करना चाहते हैं। इस भाव से तो ये कलाकृतियां उस समय के लिए बहुत ही उपयोगी और लगभग रिप्रेजेंटेशनल रूप दे रही है। तो बार बार देखना और अपने तरह से रीड करने की कोशिश ना करना मुझे लगता है यही
इससे कैसे बचेंगे।
आपने ऐसा दृश्य दिखाया हम लोगों ने कि न प्रश्न न उत्तर
मजे
करो बस मजे करो। बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद।
लेकिन
ये बात एक कष्ट से कही थी। इतिहासकार इतिहास में सिर्फ और सिर्फ अपने अतीत में बुरी चीजों को अपने देश में क्यों तलाशता है, हमको इस बात की बड़ी पीड़ा होती है। जब मैं इन सब जगहों पर जाता हूँ तो मैं देखता हूँ कि मंदिरों में पूरा जीवन है, पूरा समाज है, लेकिन हिस्टोरियन उसमें भी डिवाइसिव चीज निकालने की कोशिश करता
है। भैया मंदिर डिवाइसिव भी है
सर, मैं डिवाइसिव कहा
घोर डिवाइसिव है
होते हूँ
आदि जनता को अंदर जाने के ना इजाजत नहीं है।
नहीं,
ये प्रश्न नहीं है, ये तो एक कमेंट है विच इज इम्पोर्टेंट। लेकिन मुझे लगता है See, when I went to this place, पहले तो मैं लाइट एंड शेड देखता रहा. मेरे को तो सबसे बड़ा खेल तो एसी का सूर्योदय के टाइम पे गया. मैं 12 बजे तक वहां बैठा रहा कि भाई सनलाइट के बदलते बदलते इसमें क्या नजारा बदलते. जस्ट टू एक्सपीरियंस एन आर्ट इन डिफरेंट लाइट, दैट समथिंग वहीं जाकर हो सकता है, फोटो से कभी नहीं होता है. देन यू जस्ट रीड इट. Having done that, I have a lot of questions to answer. Dwarfs. But the dwarfs are troubling me to no end. Why are ancient Indian artists so obsessed with dwarfs? आप सांची पे चले जाओ, बुद्धिस्ट आर्ट पे जाएगा, जितने ड्वार्फ्स हैं हर चीज में ड्वार्फ दिखेंगे. जो ग्रोटेस्क दिखाना है वहां ड्वार्फ दिखेगा. बट इट इज अ शेयर्ड कल्चर. यू गो टू मिडल ईस्टर्न आर्ट, यू गो टू वेस्टर्न आर्ट. वेस्टर्न आर्ट में जो उसको क्या बोलते हैं, जो देवताओं के पीछे खड़े चेरप्स, दिस चेरप्स एंड दिस गणास आर बेसिकली द सेम फैमिली ऑफ पीपल. सो आई स्टार्ट लुकिंग एट आर्ट हिस्ट्रीज की भाई ये मामला क्या है. सो विदाउट गोइंग इन टू आर्ट हिस्ट्री आई कैनॉट understand what these chaps are doing. Then I ask this question, why this person? Aesthetically, what is he doing? Socially, what is he doing? And in terms of representation, mere ko dikh kya raha hai. You can't escape these questions. You can't escape the trap of art historian or a divisiveness. Because it's all there. It's meant to be there. भाई वहां मंदिर में दलित नहीं जा सकता, नहीं जा सकता है भाई, वो तो डिवाइसिव है. मेरे और आपके थोड़ी बनाया, वो वहां बनाया हुआ. उस मंदिर में जैसे सर ने कहा दक्षिण भारत में, मैं का वो उन्होंने बोला उस समय, मैं प्रसंग आगे नहीं बढ़ाया.
शिवा टेंपल्स,
या
देयर आर थाउजेंड्स ऑफ लिंगास, थाउजेंड्स ऑफ लिंगास, एंड इन विष्णु टेंपल्स यू हैव ओनली विष्णु.
या एब्सोल्युटली. नहीं, इट्स नॉट जस्ट दिस सर, आई विल टेल यू मोर. आई कैन मीन दिस इज नॉट अ वेरी पार्लियामेंट्री एग्जाम्पल, बट आई विल स्टिल. देयर इज अ श्रीरंगम, बहुत प्रसिद्ध मंदिर है, विष्णु का मंदिर है. इट्स सपोज टू बी द लार्जेस्ट टेम्पल एवर इन एशिया वगैरह वगैरह कहते हैं. खूब बड़ा कॉम्प्लेक्स है. उसी आइलैंड में एक शिवा टेम्पल भी उतना ही फेमस है, बड़ा पुराना. तो ये कहानी होती है कि जो शिव मंदिर के पुजारी जो हैं, वो यूरिनेट करने के लिए विष्णु मंदिर के दीवार पे जाते थे. तो हुआ ये कि ऊपर से एक कौवा था, कौवे ने उनके सिर पे एक पत्थर फेंक दिया. तो उन्होंने ऊपर देखा, बड़े गुस्से में ऊपर देखा, उन्होंने कहा कौवे ने ऊपर से एक मंदिर का ही एक हिस्से को, उसने कहा चलो मैं नीचे से इसको अंडरमाइन कर, तुम ऊपर से इसको अंडरमाइन करो. तो ये दिस द लेवल ऑफ सेक्टेरियन कॉन्फ्लिक्ट. बट व्हाट इज एस्थेटिक्स डूइंग इन ऑल दिस स्कीम? इट ऑल्सो हैज इट्स प्लेस. So yeah, like you said, you know, you have to put all these things together. You can't just say ki bhai hum sirf divisive cheez dekh rahe hain ya uniting cheez dekh rahe hain. I mean, I think hairstyle is as important. And jaise inhone sawal pucha hai, yaar itne hairstyle hai to ye kaam karne wale koi specialist to hote hi honge ki ek aadmi ke baal taiyar karne ke liye, jaise jo African परफॉर्मर्स आते हैं ना, जिनके पता नहीं कितने सैकड़ों ब्रेड्स होते हैं. मैं देख के सोचता हूँ कितने दिन लगते होंगे इनको बनाने. क्या पता सालों साल कैसे बाल बिना धोए रख सकते. दीस का इनको देख के साथ सॉरी
सर मनुष्य हैं.
एक मिनट सर, इनके
मंदिर से जुड़ा एक वरदान बता.
तो क्या इनका ऑन कर दो
ऑन ऑन कर दो
बताइए बात तभी पुष्कर गए वहाँ
जी
तो ब्रह्मा मंदिर वही है
जी ऐसे कहते हैं बहुत जगह है
कौन सी जगह होगी लेकिन वो बहुत विख्यात
असली वर्मा मंदिर
के बारे में कहा जाता है ये है कि जब ब्रह्मा यज्ञ कर रहे हैं उनकी विवाहिता पत्नी सावित्री नहीं है तो उन्होंने एक आदिवासी कन्या को विवाह की वेदी पर अपने साथ बिठा लिया तो सावित्री अप्रसन्न होकर वहां चली गई
पहाड़ के ऊपर
पहाड़ के ऊपर अब ये है कि सर इन दिनों तो अभी आजादी के बाद एक मुकदमा दायर हुआ क्योंकि वो परित्यक्ता है इसलिए ब्रह्मा मंदिर की आय का इतना हिस्सा सावित्री मंदिर को दिया जाए और वो मुकदमा अभी भी सिविल कोर्ट में पेंडिंग
है। गॉड्स आर रियल बट जो भी है पुष्कर में गौ घाट में मालपुआ खाने का मजा अलग है।
मोर विद द आईज ऑफ Professor Patel, I see more of integrated ecological approach here, not only human integration, but also integration of nature, integration of
energy. Yeah, very much.
Together. And I also noticed that Shiva and Vishnu together in this Chhattisgarh
area. In Rajasthan also, sir. Sir, if you go to Mandir, there is a Shiva temple. लेकिन उसी परिसर में विष्णु मंदिर भी बड़ा छोटा नहीं है और जो उदयपुर के जो शासक हैं वो नकुली श्री वो मंदिर नहीं है केवल उस संप्रदाय का और वहाँ के हर आदेश में ऊपर ये लिखा जाता है कि वो दीवान मानते हैं अपने को एकलिंग जी का तो लिखा जाता है एकलिंग जी प्रसादातु दीवान जी आदेशातु ये नहीं है
ये श्री विरूपाक्ष जैसे मामला
और उसी परिसर में राजस्थान में इस तरह का कोई विभेद ये दक्षिण भारत में
नहीं नहीं उन्होंने वो भी बनवाया ना नाथ द्वारा भी उन्होंने ही बनवाया
नाथ द्वारा बनवाया नहीं नाथ द्वारा तो क्या वो आए थे
हाँ उनको उन्होंने आश्रय दी
और वो गुरु बाद में गुरु बने नाथ द्वारा के जो वल्लभ संप्रदाय के जो
लेकिन दक्षिण भारत मंदिर में भी शिव मंदिर में भी विष्णु दिखेंगे आप विष्णु कोष्ठ होगा क्योंकि जो आर्किटेक्चर का कॉन्सेप्शन है उसमें इन सब परिवार देवता कहते हैं उनका होना जरूरी है उसके बिना वो मंदिर चालू नहीं हो सकता है विष्णु तो वहां बैठेंगे सूर्य भी बैठेंगे वगैरह और विष्णु का एक श्राइन जैसे जिस मंदिर के बारे में मैं काम कर रहा हूँ चिदंबरम मंदिर है बहुत ही फेमस है उसमें बहुत ये जो शैव वैष्णव वाला समस्या है वो सबसे है कि शिव के नृत्य को देखने के लिए विष्णु उपस्थित हुए और सबसे प्रमुख बाजा भी बजाते हैं जब शिव नाचते हैं तो वो उसी मंदिर में शिव के सामने विष्णु का श्राइन है तो ये कहते हैं कि चोल राजा ने उसको निकाल के फेंक दिया उसको बड़ा गुस्सा है कि हमारे शिव जी के मंदिर में विष्णु क्या कर रहा है इसको हटाओ तो उसने उसको हटा दिया अब 16th सेंचुरी में जो विजयनगर राजा थे 14th सेंचुरी में विजयनगर राजाओं ने वापस वो विष्णु की मूर्ति को वहां फिर से स्थापित किया और वो घोर शिव मंदिर है अल्टीमेट शिव मंदिर अगर कोई दक्षिण भारत में होगा तो चिदंबरम का मंदिर तो बीच शिव के एकदम सामने वो विष्णु विष्णु बैठे नहीं है लेटे हुए हैं टांग जो है शिव जी के सामने की तरफ मुंह उल्टे तरफ तो वो राजा ने वैसे लगवाया तो ये वहां के जो पंडित थे उनको बहुत गुस्सा आया, उन्होंने कहा नहीं ये नहीं चलेगा। बहुत लड़ाई हुई, दो चार पंडितों ने मंदिर के ऊपर जाके नीचे गिर के आत्महत्या भी कर ली कि भाई ये नहीं चलेगा। और राजा ने कहा ऐसी की तैसी, दो चार और मर लो कोई बात तो हम तो लगाए, हम तो मंदिर वही बनाएंगे तो ये जो है ये हमारी पुरानी परंपरा है। हमने ऐसे इसको इंटरप्रेट कर दिया
मैं आपकी पर रिग्रेट कर रहा हूं क्योंकि अगर टाइम स्लॉट किया लाइव वैसे भी ऑप्शनल है कि स्पेशल सिग्नल तो इन्होंने आई एम ग्रेटफुल टू यू कि आपने